Just the story, the screenplay. I liked the screenplay. It was Rob had it on his desk. He says there's an interesting story about Hoover, and I said, well, is this President Hoover or what? And he said, no, J. Edgar Hoover. I said, oh yeah, great. And having grown up with J. Edgar Hoover, because he was there all of my lifetime, he was always the head of the FBI. And so I thought that'd be interesting. So I went home and read it. Sometimes when you pick up a script, you just instinctively feel it might, there may be something hidden in there between the pages. And so I went home and read it, and I really liked it. So I called up Brian Grazer, who had given it to us. And I said, what's the matter? Universal doesn't want to do this? Because he's tied up over there. And he said, well, they're, you know, in a position where they weren't quite sure what they wanted their next move was. And so I said, let me take it to Warner Brothers. So I took it over to Warner's, and then Leo called up and expressed interest in the project, and because he had read it. And so everything just fell in together. Then all of a sudden there we were with Leo, and then so we just, a couple weeks later, we were preparing it. Well, you know, I didn't know too much about him, and after you study it and you go back and you read all the books on him, you still have to make your own impressions of him because he was kind of a mysterious character. And I think is very, but interesting. Interesting guy, and you didn't know where he was coming from, except that he loved investigative material and started the Bureau of Investigation and later became the Federal Bureau, and he went and lobbied for arms so they could be regular policemen, and it just sort of materialized, and 48 years later he was still doing it. Well, we found out that there was always a lot of controversy, a lot of rumors about him because he was a solitary guy, or he trusted not too many people. Obviously, Clyde Tolson was his inseparable friend, and Helen Gandy was his loyal assistant, and they had, and she was with him the whole time, and they sort of all grew up together or grew old together, and they. And he did a lot of, he manipulated a lot of things around to work for him. And I guess he had to manipulate in the political world, which was kind of tricky. But he managed to stay there. And he, a lot of people I've talked to thought he was a very affable person, very pleasant to work with. And a lot of people thought he was a son of a bitch. And so it just depends on what side of the law or him that you were on. It seemed like he was sometimes tough on people that had done well there. He seemed like that he took most of the glory for things that were going on with the FBI and their successes. And I don't know if he took the glory on any failures or not. But even after doing the picture and reading all the books that Lance Black had read to get the information, I still think of him somewhat as a mystery man.